Okay, rolling.
It's been peaceful here in the five worlds. Or is it six? For a dragon's age, we now have 12,000 treasure. Or is it 14,000?
What about this Gnasty Gnorc character? Now, I understand he's found a magic spell to turn gems into warriors for his cause.
I'll take that question. Gnasty Gnorc is a simple creature.
Simple?
He has been contained in a remote world and is no threat to the Dragon Kingdom.
No threat?
Besides, he is ugly.
Ugly? That does it!
Huh? Looks like I've got some things to do.
Thank you for releasing me, Spyro. Free 10 dragons in the artisan world, then find the balloonist. He'll transport you to the next world.
What about Gnasty Gnorc? I'm going after him.
Find dragons first. That's all I can tell you.
Keep your horns on, Spyro! You have much to learn first. Do you know what the dragonfly following you is doing? His name is Sparks, and he's helping and protecting you. Keep an eye on him and see what I mean.
Spyro, press the jump button twice to glide. And don't be afraid.
Afraid? Of what?
Falling from high mountain peaks? Plummeting into prehistoric glaciers?
Oh, that. cool flash. Do that again.
The artisan's boss is through a portal in the dragon mouth, but you are not yet ready, Spyro. First, you must complete one of the other artisan lands.
When you free a dragon or step on one of their platforms, you're saving your progress. That could be useful if you run into trouble. Not that you ever run into trouble, Spyro.
After you've freed all the dragons, pass through this fancy vortex thingamajigger. It'll take you back to the artisan home. But first, let me tell you a story.
No thanks. See ya!
Watch the dragonfly, Spyro. His color indicates his power. When he eats butterflies, he stays strong, like me.
Sure.
About a hint on gliding.
You bet.
For the longest glide, press the jump button at the top of your jump and try pressing the action button to drop down mid-flight.